Contact us to avail the combo offer of General Studies and Public Administration optional with 20% discount.
New public management, when we talk as an approach, it talks about a new managerial strategy for achieving efficiency. The goals remain same to achieve efficiency. The means, so they change. And it's newness when we talk, so it is about managerialism, which will explain what exactly it is talking, which is also characterized by neo-Taylorism. Yesterday we gave a brief, let's say that framework, that what exactly new public management is and how it is trying to achieve efficiency, of which regulation, facilitation and marketization, so they are not new. Public choice approach also emphasized, but the basis for public choice approach was individual. The focus was on individual, that is called methodological individualism, competition, institutional pluralism. Regulation was also an emphasis, but it was not, if you see the features that we wrote, so it was not a very important feature. But here when we talk about new public management, it gives a very clear emphasis that what state should do and what it should not do and how it should do. And how part becomes again very important. That's why it becomes a theory, we say, or a model, we say that. But public choice approach remains an approach consisting of a set of schools of thought who simply highlighted problems of administration, especially bureaucracy, and the relationship between state people and bureaucracy, and they explain on the basis of self-interest. So that clarity you should have, or there should be a clear understanding. And one by one, let's say that you explain it within regulation, facilitation, marketization, managerialism, there would be a set of other features. Means entire new public management can be discussed, its features basically, into three major features. And what they mean, although you know about regulation and facilitation because they are general and already we have been giving emphasis. So this regulation has its own emphasis, and we have a separate topic also on regulation. But if you see how regulation has, in brief, what has been the status of regulation? So welfare state, then corporate competitive state. Here they started talking about regulation. In welfare era, it was more of control. So, control. The regulation was known as control. And it was, let's say that, very heavy control. So, since the state was big, so it exercised strict control. So strict control, etc. So you may be aware about MRTP Act. Monopolistic Restrictive Trade Practices Act. So it was a law which was to deal against monopoly. But this law resulted into, similarly, we had Foreign Exchange Regulation Act, the two popular laws. And similarly, we had Industrial Policy Resolution, 1956. If you take these three laws, so they restricted the role of private sector. The private sector role was restricted in India. And government played big role. So if you see in industrial policy resolution, categorization of the undertakings, enterprises in terms of A, B, C. So A, B, C, D. And in that A category, complete state. In B category, only supplement role of market. C category, they can play, let's say, big role. So licensing, etc., it results into what we say license Raj and inspector Raj. So there was control which was characterized till 1991. It is in this backdrop, if you say in Indian context, and if you see in their context, be it US or UK, etc., so they had entered, a state had entered in the field of business, especially New Deal, welfare, etc. program. And that's why they started talking that it should regulate. It should not control, rather it should regulate. Means it should not restrict, rather it should give them chance and it should regulate their affairs. Regulation is different from administration, which will tell you properly when we'll take regulatory topic. But regulation is different, administration is different. Administration is about controlling the environment, maintaining law and order, security, stability. Regulation is about not controlling the environment. Regulation is about encouraging the environment and creating a level playing field through innovations. That you can compare on the basis of comparing the role of administration with role of SEBI. The SEBI is not supposed to control the market. SEBI is supposed to regulate the market. What it regulates, so it will have to create an environment so that it is market friendly. But let's say that when administration is performing its role, so it will maintain, control the environment. Let's say that traffic management. Traffic management is also an act of regulation, but they are controlling your behavior and penalizing your behavior. So when there is any violation, so there is penalization, and that is a very harsh penalization. Once you violate traffic rules, so there is 5,000 fine. So it is not regulation, it is administration. But if you see regulation, so regulation has to create a level playing field. So that is what they are talking term regulation. And regulation is, let's say that, accompanied by facilitation. Because both they go hand in hand. That is called basically creating a business friendly environment. We need to create a business friendly environment. One important aspect of business friendly environment is good infrastructure. This. Second is called liberalization. Liberalization. So, less control. There should be less control. That is called decontrol. So, you know that it is abolished. It was abolished. It was also abolished. And this was changed. The FERA changed to FEMA. Management came. Foreign Exchange Management Act. This. So, you should know that how regulation, facilitation, government is started, and that is how it is giving, creating a more business friendly environment. And this result into effects, if you see, so establishment of SEBI. The SEBI is established, IRDA established, right? TRAI established. We had some important prominent regulatory institutions established also in India. So, when you go for regulation and facilitation, then it will automatically result into, when you go for this regulation and facilitation, it will automatically result into de-bureaucratization. Because these things, before SEBI, TRAI and IRDA, they were regulated by bureaucracy. Who regulated that sector? Which institution regulated that sector? So, bureaucracy. So, when you create SEBI, when you create IRDA, when you create any other institution, so when you create any other institution, so it is going to take the role of bureaucracy. Because as of now, it is performed by ministry, department, etc. So, this will give rise to automatically this de-bureaucratization. And when you have de-bureaucratization, you will have to make your laws simple. Laws, rules, process. So, this would be made simple. Simple and business friendly. So, that will itself reduce, let's say that. It will simplify process and procedures. That is how we have done this. So, when we have abolished this, this is how the example, simple. The simplification of rules, process, procedures. That will bring greater flexibility. It will promote speed, efficiency. Like say, we have created IBC. Insolvency Bankruptcy Code. The Insolvency Bankruptcy Code is improved version of so far any such legal measure taken on rewriting the debts. If you are aware certain elements of economy, so it is the best law so far. So before that we had adopted a series of steps. And that a series of steps, they were not effective. Finally, we have adopted IBC, which is better than past laws. And that will make, let's say, create speed, efficiency, minimize law, rules, etc. And also bureaucratic. So, bureaucracy, there will be automatically de-bureaucratization. So, it is in this context, when we say regulation facilitation. So, new public management has some important terms. Although regulation facilitation is a term, but it has also terms like catalyzer or catalyst. State should work as a catalyst. State should work as a steerer. Very popular term for new public management. So, steerer, we say not rover. So catalyst driven, right, steerer, not rover, this. So facilitator, not producer, producer, actor, and director. Means it should itself not do, rather let market does and it should facilitate. The role of state should be to facilitate. So, producer means it itself, let's say welfare state entered in producing goods and services, means especially goods. Rover is the sense, again let's say that, keep playing big role, laying down the things, and rather than let's say steerer means ke, it should be a more of a driving force. It should give the direction. It should, let's say, have policy measures which can give certain direction to investment. So, catalyst driven, it should, let's say, that play such a role that there is encouragement of business. So these are some of the terms which are also, let's say, that are used when we talk about regulation and facilitation. And it is very popular, especially this steerer. State should play the role of steerer, not rower. This, and even you will find that it is in advertisement. When government gives some advertisements in newspaper, you can find, especially in Indian Express in past, when Prime Minister was emphasizing on the role of the state as a steerer rather than rower. Means present government follows under minimum government, maximum governance philosophy. And this is how we mean by this regulation and facilitation. Then let's go to marketization. In marketization, again it is known, but we say privatization and we say contracting out. This competition. So these are already the features that you know, but it further, let's say, that key adds on other such features, important features. It brings the concept of user charges. User charges. This, then customer orientation, customer client orientation. This. So it will also reject all those concepts, welfare, subsidies, social justice and public interest. But since they are known, already known, it's very interesting to know this user charges, because user charges will bring also customer orientation. Basically, it says that government should or not only spend. What does it mean? It means government should have government should have also profit motive, not service motive. It's a big thing. Means it should charge for the services it provides. It should charge for the services it delivers. Then how we'll know this? So let's take any, let's say that, key power, power supply, water, right, this, gas, and transportation road, what you have? Right, user charges concept. User charges concept. So nowadays you will find on this bills, on this tolls, and that is what client or customer means those who can pay. Can pay will get quality of service. This is market concept. So you'll find that nowadays power sectors in India also, right? Power, water, gas. So it is charged by government. Toll on this, so it is PPP. All PPP projects where people pay this. Before that scenario was, so before this, the scenario was what? Free service. अभी भी लोग चाहते हैं free service. An electoral promise. Electoral promises. What? Power free. अभी भी पंजाब में highly subsidized. So it is this user charges concept already contracting out, privatization, competition, yes, it is talked. But user charges brings customer oriented. So this is entire this process will be customer orientation. And state moves from service orientation to profit. This the state shift to profit orientation. That is how it becomes more like business type. Business type. That's why they say that state should function like business. State should function like business. This. And you'll find that reforms have happened in power sector, in water supply management, gas supply sector, road transportation, many other sectors, on the basis of concept of user charges. It is a very popular term also, user charges concept. And government should earn, it should not spend, because what we have created on the basis of service motive is that state should serve rather than earn. So there is a negative perception about profit and earning. But when they say that there should be user charges, so there is a merit. There is merit in this. By the way, what is the merit when they bring user charges concept?
Competition.
Quality with right. Innovation and sustainability. When we have service motive, so a state is incurring the cost in delivering of that service, and today and tomorrow a state would become bankrupt. Because a state needs, how the money will come? After all, when a state is delivering to people, so it can deliver free 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 10 years, not 20 years, 30 years, 40 years. After all, behind each and every service delivery, there is cost. And if that cost is not, let's say that, borne out by the people, at least at minimal level, so you know what will happen. So there will be accumulation of all such, and one day a time would come that the state is not in a position to sustain. First, second, that when we go for user charges concept, client orientation means there will be different players in the market, and they will deliver, or government it will deliver, it will promote competition, and when it will promote competition, it will promote quality and it will bring innovation, and hence in long run it will be sustainable. Sustainable not as per the sustainable development concept, sustainable that government can deliver that service right, not only in short run but also in long run. Let's take why power condition means, power means electricity, quality of supply in Uttar Pradesh has not improved. Those who belong to Uttar Pradesh and let's say Bihar, it has not improved. Why? So first thing is that it is largely, it is a service, not user charges. Second thing is the government has not still introduced that user charges concept in terms of billing the power supply consumption on the basis of metering system. Rather, government still sends bill in bulk, common sense basis. अच्छा, मई महीने का कितना होगा तो पांडे जी दे दीजिए 1000, राइट. सो वो क्या है कि वो बल्क सिस्टम है अभी भी. तो व्हेन देयर इज अ बल्क सिस्टम ऑफ 1000 बिल, 2000 बिल, सो पीपल आर डिस्करेज्ड. सम पीपल डू नॉट कंज्यूम ऑफ 1000 एंड 2000, एंड सम पीपल आर कंज्यूमिंग इवन ऑफ 5000. But a person who is consuming a 5000 is paying 2000. The person who is not consuming 2000 is paying 2000. So there is a power theft. And it has also not brought realization among people, service and cost. Mystical notion means ki service ke naam pe aap kuch bhi kar sakte hain. Matlab power free hai. Ya logon ne mindset banaya ki power to free hi hona chahiye. Means electricity supply should be free. This, how come? और अगर सरकार free नहीं दे रही है तो हम heater जलाएंगे. Right, यूपी में क्या होता है आपको पता है, those who belong to Uttar Pradesh. Culture. तो आज transformer लगाया, कल जो है transformer. Right, राम नाम सत्य हो गया उसका. Anyhow, so the question is that, government is incurring huge cost, frequent incidents of transformers getting dead. So I don't know how, what it is told, burnt or what it happens, right? So transformer frequent, it is incurring huge cost. How is it sustainable? And metering, aap metering karo, logo ke paas usse jyada knowledge hai meter ka, wo ऐसे की तैसे कर देगा. इट मीन्स यू शुड हैव इनोवेटिव मीटरिंग सिस्टम सो दैट इट इज टेम्पर प्रूफ. नो, द सम इंजीनियर्स आर हियर इन क्लास, आई गेस, डू वी हैव टेम्पर प्रूफ मीटरिंग इन इंडिया?
नो सर. राइट,
सो इनोवेशन, वी नीड इनोवेशन, दिस इज एन एरिया ऑफ इनोवेशन. You develop such a metering meter, means metering system, that it cannot be tempered. So that is what, let's say that you have to bring innovation, and government, at least you don't pay 5000, don't pay 1000, but you should get a message to them that see, there is a charge for the service. Means whatever the service you get, it has a cost. And when it has a cost, you become more aware. And when you become more aware, so you become more economical. Right? तो जिसके घरों में इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल पे किया जाता है, तो जब कोई भी चीज़ स्विच ऑन नहीं छोड़ा जाता है, isn't it? People have developed habit of switching it off. Is it like that? When they are not using it. So that is what you should understand by this concept. And that is how the positive aspect of their user charges concept. Can we say this is the merit of user charges concept?
Sir, Delhi government provide electricity for free up to 200 units. So isn't that reasonable for long run?
Yes. Now let's say that again it is, this is what we are saying, public choice approach, electoral politics, self-interest. Second thing is that yes, it serves also because our society has, let's say, stratification, rich, poor, middle, high level of stratification. So rather I will say that Delhi government should adopt a more innovative approach, area-wise approach. Not uniform, let's say that 200 units free and then thereafter you will charge. Rather, you should have area wise. There are some localities. Why you should, let's say that people living in DLF, so why they should be getting free electricity? People living in bahut sare heavens type of apartment construct kiya gaya hai on this land. Right. So they claim that it is like heaven. So those who are living in heaven, so थोड़ा सा उनको तो cost bear करना चाहिए, isn't it? Those who are in hell, they will get help.
Yes, sir.
So the question is that you need to adopt innovative approach. Since you cannot manage area-wise approach, that's why you go for a flat rate. Right? So it has scope for innovation.
People can argue with, they can say it is discrimination against
not them. It is not discrimination. Rather, you need to imbibe in the people, let's say, you share some responsibility as a citizen. If you, why a person earning, let's say, 2 lakh per month should get subsidized bill? Or even 1 lakh per month? A person who is earning 1 lakh per month, he is getting a subsidized bill. A person who is earning 10,000, he is also getting a subsidized bill. How can you treat both same? And जब ये सब्सिडी इंट्रोड्यूस नहीं किया था केजरीवाल ने तो सबको बिल पे करना पड़ता था, इट वॉज नॉट फ्री. तो इट इज रिग्रेसिवनेस और प्रोग्रेसिवनेस, दिस वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. इट मीन्स ऑलरेडी पीपल ऑफ दिल्ली वर पेइंग बिल्स, राइट? तो दे वर केपेबल ऑफ पेइंग. Let's have more efficient approach. This, you give subsidies to people, those who are not better off, identify the localities, and those people who are better off, they should not get subsidy. You should be very clear in this. That's why even gas cylinders also, those who can pay, they should give it up. This. Anyhow, so that is what, let's say that user charges concept they are talking, and it to enhance the quality of service and to enhance efficiency, as well as let's say that what we say about sustainability in delivery of those services. But it is based on market principle, which let's say certainly people, some people will not like, but you cannot deny the merit behind this principle, this practice.
Sir, making a power sector private, will it help in the efficiency or for the consumer also? Because there were some certain cases in which we can see that the private sector, private companies, they are like earning a huge profit and they are not providing the equivalent services which are there still with the government sector which they provide.
That's why, let's say, privatization with regulation. Privatization without regulation will not succeed.
And sir,
yes. See, we are talking, let's some other aspects are also related. It is power means privatization plus regulation plus governance approach. This you have to understand. That's why they have used the term governance. We don't need big government, we need better governance. What is governance? It is a collective way of solving the problems of society. So what is collective way? It is governance. So those private entities who are going to get the responsibility to supply electricity, means power, they should know that they cannot behave purely on commercial term. Rather, they will have to behave on user charges as per governance concept. They should earn profit, but not they should make profit as their end rather than service delivery. And if you will not regulate, so it will result into, you know already what it will happen, crony capitalism. So if you are going for privatization, accordingly you need to enhance the standard of regulation. Right. This. Anyhow, so let's take next feature. Like income tax means what you are saying? Means question.
The rationale behind a user charge, the same rationale behind the user charge is behind the income tax, because we give up to 5 lakhs, there is no income tax.
See, taxation has been there, let's say that in the era of marketization, taxation should be progressive. This is how I can say that. It should not be regressive. That is, the tax burden on people should be less. And share of indirect tax should be more than share of indirect tax. This is how the concept, that is what we have been trying to make after 1991. Right.
Then, sir, how the work of traffic man comes under this control and the work of service of facilitation
will come, wait for chapter 4 here, why you are dragging me means to that details. If you are not able to understand, so this is not a place to make you understand. We will teach you in regulation.
Okay.
Regulation topic. Right?
Okay.
Let's proceed. So managerialism, it means let managers manage. Make managers. Thank you. So, if you see in this what they are saying, result orientation, which you are aware, performance measurement, new thing, performance based contract, new thing, incentivization, new thing, autonomy, empowerment to those who take decision, new thing. They have been part and parcel of what Wilson was talking. And this will be also known as management professionalism. And it is, let's say, in contrary to what bureaucracy practices or what bureaucracy is. Basically, they say that these should be the features for administration. Such features should be incorporated in administration. Such features should be incorporated in administration. Since they resemble to Taylor, we'll talk separately, but just we are relating. Since they resemble to Taylor, that's why it has been told by Pollitt as neo-Taylorism. It also resembles to what Wilson was talking. But it's not same. That is what we have to distinguish. So, whether Wilson and new public management have similarity and differences, so we have to distinguish, but first we'll understand that what does it mean and how it will, let's say, that bring change in administration.
Contact us to avail the combo offer of General Studies and Public Administration optional with 20% discount.